certainly be worse. I wouldn't say it's as nice as yesterday, but
Monday, remember that?
Yeah. Oh, whew. Never forget. Yeah, it's getting a little cooler today, of course, at least when it compared to the average, but I think temperatures are actually going to be warmer than they were yesterday, just not with as much sunshine, which we've managed to hold on to a little bit more of that, which is really nice. That does change, though. That next round of rain that we're expecting arrives overnight tonight, and then the weekend is looking, for the most part, good, but there's a little caveat to that, and I'll explain to that to you in just a moment. Not everyone has that leftover sunshine. Some clouds have rolled in, especially over northern New York, but the Champlain Valley has at least some sunshine, and especially up towards the Northeast Kingdom, Central and Eastern Vermont, in great shape with some of that. But again, some clouds creeping in ahead of that next system. You can already see the hints of that with clouds over Canada, Lake Ontario, and some showers associated with that too. And that whole system will be moving overhead of us over the next day and a half, and it's going to bring us some pretty heavy rain and a pretty good round of that for parts of our area. In fact, most of our area. Now, 56 right now in Burlington, 53 in Plattsburgh, 55 in Montpelier, and with that sun, not feeling too good. If you're in the shade or under those clouds, might feel a little more brisk, but overall here I think we're in great shape for the rest of the day. 57 in Ludlow, 62 in Brandon, 60 in Rochester. As you can see, a couple more degrees to go as we head into the afternoon hours. 60 in Island Pond, 63 in Morrisville, 61 in Northfield, 62 in Middlebury, and then stretching up towards 61 in Burlington, and right around 57 in South Hero on the water. It's going to be a little bit cooler. Same goes for Keysville, 59 there, 58 in Plattsburgh, and 58 in Malone. Like I said, clouds continue to fill out. You'll get a little sun here or there throughout the rest of the day, but more and more of these as the evening goes on. The rain will hold off, though. Maybe a spot shower at the very most, but it's going to be a not too bad of an afternoon. Just again, not quite as bright as it was yesterday. Here are those showers creeping in. Probably around midnight and beyond, you're going to find some scattered, spotty showers, maybe a couple of quick downpours. But that's changing even more into the morning watch as this band becomes more widespread. You get these oranges and yellows, and that is the downpours that we're talking about here. And as you look at the time here, this is falling right around the time a lot of us are headed out to work tomorrow morning. So keep in mind that it will be very wet, and some of that heavy rain will stick around through midday. Second part of your Friday afternoon will be not quite as widespread when it comes to that rain as that whole thing continues to exit. However, it doesn't leave out some pockets of that heavy rain in the mix all the way through the evening drive. So just have that in mind, that although we will get some breaks for the afternoon, it won't quite be done until overnight as more and more of those showers move out. Left with some clouds on Saturday morning, and we end up with some sunshine for the afternoon. It's going to be a beautiful day, and we should be dry all the way through at least Sunday morning, if not even longer. A nice widespread half inch of that rain is expected. Wouldn't be shocked to see a few places near and above an inch of the rain between tonight and all the way through your Friday. So a nice soaker there, but we, like I said, dry up on Saturday, a little on the cool side when it comes to our averages, but we're looking at some sunshine, which will be nice. Increasing clouds on Sunday, maybe some showers to the south. However, most of those will hold off for your Mother's Day and wait until about Monday, but it will be a wet start to next work week.